was something that would further disenchant people. To his credit, upon his return to the United States, Senator McCain made a critical public statement dissonant with George W. Bush's choice to support the dynastic rule, and had been vocal on the downward path of democratic institutions in our country since then. At the time, the great powers believed that an educated, English-speaking son of an authoritarian ruler would become a reformer. Today, when President Aliyev II has brought Azerbaijan to the verge of exclusion from the Council of Europe, I see that some external forces are willing to repeat the mistake of the year 2003. This time they seem to feel affection for one part of the ruling family against another. This is driven by the same mistaken vision that someone from within the corrupt and nasty oligarchy inflated on steroids with oil and gas revenue may become a reformer even without a proven ability to compete in a democratic race. That is a direct path to even greater repression. We have seen that in the example of Aliyev, who has been less skilled than his father, less competitive, and therefore more repressive. Even worse repressions is going to happen if the clandestine rules of supporting a convenient dictator continues his style in a different tradition. We in the Republican Alternative are working to gain support of the same middle class which some external planners believe should support the second dynastic succession. We are aware of the economic roots of that social group not always being healthy. Currently, those rules are too much dependent on the government's wasteful spending of oil and gas revenue. However, that class is just tired of the system in which their economic rights are not protected, in which they always have to demonstrate political loyalty, and yet that demonstration is not a guarantee of their security. Like communism, the system takes just too many innings. In a typical Azerbaijani middle-class family, when it comes to assessment of risks, their occupation, plan B usually is not about changing professional priorities or business plan, but about emigration. We are willing to create for them a talent rewarding system in the economy and in the government so that they stay and move our country. Due to our perseverance in this fight for democracy, the Republican Alternative has achieved a level of name recognition sufficient to launch a victorious election campaign. Not only we are widely recognized, but the vast majority of people who recognize our platform are inclined to vote for us. Our task of building up on that reputation is undermined by continuous harassment by authorities, such as travel ban and administrative arrests of activists. The government has been doing a number of similar things in a smart way, with reliance on oil revenue-based social contract and some corrupt internationals. However, their revenue is falling, and its corrupt international support base is also being exposed and thrown out of politics. The latter is to a large extent due to our efforts and international solidarity receiving from the Western democratic circles. Taking this opportunity to speak to the true friends of democratic progress in Azerbaijan, I would like to emphasize that Republican Alternative will continue its pursuit of peaceful change. Azerbaijan has always been a very special story of a Muslim nation with strong democratic aspirations.
Well, my second reason of being feeling uncomfortable here is that I'm not a human rights defender, I've never been, and I'm not even an anti-activist, I just have an academic degree, and I'm staying in those programs. I cannot do that anymore for political reasons because I'm a major opposition of the party. So, and also, the time limit is severe. There's almost nothing left for me to talk about. So, anyway, I'll try to do my best. Of course, Ilhan Mammadov should have presented his personal story, and I'm not the perfect person to talk about being a low man, close friend, but the difficulty is that it's always, you know, for professional biographers, it's difficult to storyify the same experience of someone else's life. So, I hope that you, and most importantly, Ilhan, will forgive me if I talk more about reality, about the emotions that I have about Ilhan Mammadov. And this is actually our vision in politics. We do not personalize what we do. Because one of the problems of our country is that everything becomes too much personal. Our country is, if I may say so, under-institutionalized and over-personalized. So people pay too much attention to personalities, which goes back to some traditional ways of life and dealings with public affairs in Azerbaijan. We want to break it, and I think we've managed to break it. We decided from the very beginning that, apart from any other mistakes that politicians can and normally do, there are two strategic mistakes that politicians should avoid. One is self-glorification. This is a typical mistake that politicians do, especially when they are in opposition, and also when they are in power. They attribute all the good things to themselves, and they avoid being part of some injustices and mistakes that their bosses led to. So we decided not to glorify ourselves. Whatever we do, we present it as a collective achievement. We've managed to build a collective identity for our organization, which is real. This is a shortcut of Republican Alternative. I will tell you why we chose this name later. And of course, when you glorify yourself, you reason yourself becoming a bubble or a balloon. And as the saying goes, the fate of a balloon is on the needle point, so you can blow up immediately at any time. Second political mistake that a politician can do is self-victimization. Okay, societies do feel empathy and respect to those who were victims of political repression or oppression. In that way, Azerbaijan is no different. And of course, we do feel support from the public, but when you enter the politics with that background, victim of political repression. I don't know how it works in your respect. In Azerbaijan, it doesn't look like a useful tool for a politician to employ, because people want to see a successful person. A person who has self-esteem, self-confidence, most importantly. And when you keep talking about your prison life or how you were victimized by the regime, you will never reach the top of the political pyramid. So we do not victimize ourselves, even though every one of us has suffered something. Of course, the greatest suffering for the young man is in prison. I lost my job, for example, which I cannot teach anyone back to second person. Many others also left, some lost their property, some lost their job, some lost their freedom. And we do not elaborate on that. Now, who is the Republican Alternative? Why we chose this? Because in 2009, when we first decided to establish this organization, we saw that our country is gradually drifting away from Republican ideals and values. And as I mentioned, there was sort of proto-monarchical ways of ruling the country. One vote for theoretical reasons argued that democracy and monarchy Now, Realis and Alternative stands for not only being in opposition to the government, which is now in the country, but also it's an ambition to change the system from fundamentally change the system. We're not claiming that we are better than the government. We never blame the government. In fact, all the problems and world the sufferings we have faced is also part of our choice. It's not just the government process. We chose to go this way. We chose to live this life. So it is two sides. It's okay, the government offered us several opportunities. I myself was offered by a certain position in the government. I could have built a successful academic career. I decided to continue with what we have started in 2009, and that's why I'm still an environmentalist. I try to find my It is also options. So you have to remain positive. It's not about being optimistic. It's about being cool about your faith. It's about being staying positive about what you've been doing. Probably this is the only way of remaining and continuing in the successful way of doing your career. Also, we have managed as we are to attract the attention of young generation. This is perhaps one of the biggest reasons that Real is successful, because we are on the wave of the generation change. And generation change is the most important change. It's unstoppable. No political force can stop it. During the last 30 years, the new generation grew up. 30 years is a very important milestone. 30 years ago, or almost 30 years ago, Soviet Union collapsed. A colleague, the professor from China, mentioned that he grew up in China, was born in China. I was born in Soviet Union, and I grew up in Soviet Union, and I received Soviet education. I don't blame the past, don't get me wrong. What I'm saying is that this is a completely different system, which we were trying to get rid of. Not only in Azerbaijan, Russia themselves were trying to get into the system. And now we're somehow again trapped in the world we have been trying to get away. This has been a kind of deja vu, especially when you saw what Putin is saying and doing. And of course, Russia still has a cultural leverage on Azerbaijan because of the political past. But when we see what Erdogan has been doing in Turkey, and where the majority of our population is Turkic. So that's why the cultural language of Turkey is a big factor. And when you see the Russian television being entirely anti-Western, anti-liberal, and the Turkish television anti-Western and anti-liberal, then when you try to build an environment in Azerbaijan which is heavily brainwashed by Russian and Turkish television, it is also it's a challenge. But new generation is different. I'm going to be less hopeful because new generation. They have different worldview. There's some risks as well, because my generation, we consider the independence of our country as the greatest achievement in the history. And by doing so, by viewing independence as the greatest achievement, we somehow overlook the importance of freedom. Now, what I see in the new generation, they take independence for granted. Yes, they fight for freedom, and this is good. But in their fight for freedom, they seem to overlook the importance of independence. So, what we as Real is trying to do is to bring this new nonsense in peace, because freedom without independence is inconceivable, and independence without freedom is incomplete. And, anyway, of course, the time it was here. I apologize for taking your time, especially the lady from Russia. I have your time, and I will forgive you. Thank you. Thank you.